Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a soul like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind.
Representing different aspects and interests in Rachael's life, and Sarah is going to tell us about them.
We bring forward Mom's handbag. We bring this forward as a sign of how much she loved her fashion, even down here in civilization. We bring forward her sunglasses as a sign of how much she loved wearing them. It could be winter time, it could be raining, but she was always wearing them. And she always said it was a great way so no one could see her eyes. We bring forward her Crocs because they never went anywhere without her, even on holidays. Even on the coldest day, she was always wearing them. They were even glued back together at one stage. And yeah, that's it.
The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So you're welcome as we gather today to celebrate the Requiem Mass for the repose of the soul of Rachael Twomey. We gather today to pray for Rachael, and we ask God to grant her eternal rest and peace. And to help us to do that, we begin by thanking the Lord for his mercy and by asking for his forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty and faithful Creator, all things are of your making, all people are shaped in your image. We now entrust the soul of Rachael to your goodness. In your infinite wisdom and power, work in her your merciful purpose, known to you alone from the beginning of time. Console the hearts of those who love her, in the hope that all who trust in you will find peace and rest in your kingdom. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. So I invite those who are doing the first reading and the second reading to come forward, please.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food, On this mountain he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped, we exult, and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Revelation. John saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared now, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city and the new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, as beautiful as a bride all dressed for her husband. Then I heard a loud voice called from the throne, "You see the city. Here God lives among men. He will make his home among them. They shall be his people, and he will be their God. His name is God with them. He will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There will be no more death and no more mourning or sadness. The world of the past has gone." Then the one sitting on the throne spoke. "Now I am making the whole of creation new," he said. "I will give water from the well of life free to anybody who is thirsty. It is the rightful inheritance of the one who proves victorious, and I will be his God, and he has a son to me." The word of the Lord.
Jesus Christ is the firstborn from the dead. To him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. We stand so for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the first day of the week, two of the disciples were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem, and they were talking about all that had happened. Now as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side, but something prevented them from recognizing him. He stopped them. He said to them, "What matters are you discussing as you walked along?" They stopped short, their faces downcast. Then one of them called Cleopas answered him, "You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there these last few days? What things, he asked. All about Jesus of Nazareth, they answered, who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of our God and of the whole people, and how our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death and had him crucified. Our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this is not all. 2 whole days have gone by since it all happened, and some women from our group have astounded us. They went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they did not find the body, they came back to tell us they had seen a vision of angels who declared he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the women had reported, but of him they saw nothing. Then he said to them, "You foolish men, so slow to believe the full message of the prophets. Was it not ordained that the Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory?" Then, starting with Moses and going through all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scriptures that were about himself. When they drew near to the village which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. Now while he was with them at table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them, and their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of bread. This is the Gospel of the Lord. You can sit down there for a couple of minutes. I suppose Rachael didn't quite spend 24 years in Drumnagapple, but almost just a month and a piece short of it. And in that much time, I suppose herself and John built a house, a home, a family, a life, a farm. And over the past few days, the words "why" and "if" have been used an awful lot. And I suppose it is part of who we are as human beings that we look for answers and for reasons and for explanations. But I'm not sure if we will ever get the answer or the explanation or the reason why Rachael felt she had to leave us. We're here today to pray for Rachael. We're here to ask God to grant her the peace in the next life that she couldn't find in this life. We are here too to pray for John and Jason and Sarah and Megan and Leah, Peggy and Mike, and Rebecca and Ruth. And we're here to show our support for you. And I suppose you know yourselves how you have experienced that support in the past few days, and how people have been there for you and have, I suppose, struggled to say things at times, but they still have been there for you. And I suppose, you know, in the days to come, there'll be times when we'll say the right thing to you, and there'll be times when we'll say the wrong thing, and there'll be times when we'll do the wrong thing for you, and there'll be times when we'll do the right thing for you. But whatever we do, it will be done with a good intention. Because I suppose, if somebody falls into a hole, our first reaction is to try and pull them out. Sometimes we succeed in doing that. Sometimes we might nearly pull the arm off them, or dislocate their shoulder, or pull off their sleeve, or fall into the hole ourselves. But we're starting with good intentions. And as human beings too, we have sometimes the capacity to surprise ourselves by how we reach out and support others. And as I said, for yourselves, Rachael's family, that is something you have been experiencing over the past few days, and I hope it is something you will continue to experience. And so we stand and invite those who are leading us in the prayers of the faithful to come forward.
Bring all the dead into the light that no darkness can overpower. May we all meet in joy with you, Lord, hear us.
Lord, praise to hear us.
That God may grant peace to all those who have died in Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, praise to hear us.
We pray for all those who mourn. May their tears be wiped away and may their mourning be turned to joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, praise to hear us.
For all who mourn today for Mom, that they will receive strength to assist them in their sadness and grief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, praise to hear us.
Grieve not, nor speak of me with tears, but laugh and talk of me as though I were beside you. I loved you always. 'Twas heaven here with you all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
So inside in the church here today, outside in the yard, people who are watching us on the live streaming, and Ken and Paul Willoughby back west as well, we're all today here to pray for Rachael. We pray that God will grant her eternal rest and peace, and that he will grant to yourselves, his family, comfort, consolation and support. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, to your servant Rachael, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition to Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy and Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Fintan, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here as faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise that they offer themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and health and well-being, and paying their homage to the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, our spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers and all things may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service out of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we deliver from eternal damnation and count on the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, and become for us the body and blood of the most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension to heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as one you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar and high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar of the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servant Rachael, who has gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant her, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who thus sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, to whom we continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. So we stand and pray to our Heavenly Father in the words our Saviour gave us.
Give us this day our day. lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So just for communion, I'll stay inside here, and Father Pat will go outside the door, so if anybody outside wants Holy Communion, you can come to Father Pat and he'll look after you.
I pray you'll be our eyes and watch us as we go, and teach us to be wise in times when we don't know.
Give us faith so we'll
give us faith so we Quando sono solo, sono risanta monche le parole. Si loce non è luce in stanza, manco le illusse lole. Se non si c'è tu con me, con me. Sulle finestre mostre tutti il mio cuore. A se c'è chiudi dentro me, la luce c'è, a m'incontrana per strada. Time to say sono sole, sogni all'orizzonte, ma che parole. E io sei oceone con me, tu me lune l'occio con me. Mio sole, tu sole con me, io con me, con me, con me, con me. Time to say goodbye. Partirò.
Dear Mom, I just wanted to say in front of everyone here today how much we love you. Yes, we had our differences, but we always made up in the end. Whenever we needed timber or anything from up in the shed, Jason would always say, take up Mom's car, as mine's German perfection and too clean for the yard. Please remember, forever and ever, we love you more than words can say, and I know you're at peace within yourself, and we can only hope that you are there beside us in spirit to guide us along our journeys of life. Thank you.
Whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, surround the family of Rachael with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us praise the Lord. And so we stand for the prayers of commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Rachael, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Rachael in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our sister forever. And in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
in a